I know you guys got a lot of questions. I'm going to do my best to answer as many as I can. Let's get the show on the road. Here we go. All right, the first question comes in from June Rodriguez of the United States. The question is, how powerful can we expect Black Adam to be? Well, great question, Jude. Thank you for asking that question. As we all know, Black Adam is one of the most powerful superheroes, anti-heroes, villains, whatever you want to call Black Adam. He is one of the most powerful in the DC universe. But as we all know, the superheroes, they have to exhibit a little bit of restraint when it comes to taking care of the bad guys, if you will, or taking care of the people who are opposite them, who are opposing them, who are in their way. But this idea that you could take all of Black Adam's powers and he does not practice restraint, that makes for a really powerful combination, and one that's explosive, one that's very dangerous, and one that is ultimately, very likable, to me at least. All right, next question comes in from Jaden Marvel of Singapore. The question is, if you could take any DC character to join you in an adventure, who would it be and why? The number one choice on who I would love to take with me on an adventure would be Wonder Woman. And I'll tell you why. No, I know what you guys are thinking. Oh, of course you would, Rock. No. Look, Gal is my friend. She's a very good friend of mine. But the character of Wonder Woman is one that I have such a tremendous amount of respect for. I've always thought that this combination of Wonder Woman and Black Adam would make an incredible pairing. So this idea that we would go on an adventure together is something very cool. The other part to this answer is, I always thought that it might be cool to hang out with Superman. That would be cool, right? I mean, we're kind of similar in terms of our powers, our strengths, our speeds. Because look, at the end of the day, you never know. Black Adam and Superman could become friends. Or they won't. Who knows? Maybe we'll see. All right, this next question comes from Caleb Hammocks from the UK. The question is, out of all the characters you could have played, what is it about Black Adam that stuck out to you that makes him unique? It's a great question, Caleb. Thank you very much. Caleb, I hope I pronounced your name right. As many of you know, Black Adam has been with me for a very, very long time. This has been a project that has been in development for a very long time, over 10 years, 10 years plus with myself, our producer, Hiram Garcia, who's the president of 7 Bucks Productions. I mean, this has been in our DNA and in our wiring for such a long time. One of the main things that I always loved and admired about Black Adam was, number one, he was an anti-hero. He is an anti-hero. I love that. I love that the line is a little blurred. I love that he doesn't toe the mark. I love that he doesn't walk the line. I love that he has his own sense of Black Adam justice. I also love the fact that his origins are that of a slave. When the origins are that of somebody who is enslaved, his people enslaved, his family enslaved, and he's felt the burdens and the pressures of a larger entity holding him down until he can't take it anymore. And when you come from that place, it's just a different energy and a vibe, different mana that you have. So I've always loved that about Black Adam, which informs how Black Adam operates, how he sees justice, how he delivers justice. And I've always appreciated that about Black Adam. Okay, this next great question is from Ayush Butola from India. I hope I pronounced your name right. So from India, thank you for this question. Will you stay faithful to the fact Black Adam, at the end of the day, is a ruthless keeper of justice and not a stereotypical villain or a hero? I love this question. And my stripped away, honest answer is yes. You know, as we all know, there's many variations and iterations of Black Adam that we have all fallen in love with over the years. And what I can promise you is the Black Adam that I feel in my heart is the right one to root our story in the beginning, this origin story. This is a character that will possess all the qualities that we have loved, regardless of what variation of Black Adam you've loved, which he is ruthless. He's a ruthless keeper of justice. He is the judge, the jury, and the executioner. And he believes in an eye for an eye, and he will always do everything he can to protect his people, more so protect his family. So that is my answer, and thank you for your question. All right, so here we go. This next question, it's a video question coming in via video. All right, cool, roll it.
Yeah, hey, what's up, Dwayne? How you doing, man? My question is, I just want to know how you're feeling about the fact that I'm coming for your squat game. I'm just curious.
Well, you know what? Look, I'm glad, Noah, that you said that, because there's a difference between coming for my squat game, different than, you know, Adam Smasher coming for Black Adam's squat game. It's a big difference. So you know what? I welcome it. Dude, good to see you, man. How you been?
Good to see you, too. Oh, I've been really good, man. Excited to be here. Excited to be a part of the team, man.
Man, it's so cool to have you be part of this team and to bring Adam Smasher to life, JSA to life, to bring this entire universe that we're going to create together to life. Well, talk to me a little bit about your workouts. I know you've been training hard despite us being locked down. How has that been going? Let the fans know.
It's been really good. You know, there's a lot of different precautions that we take now, but it's been a lot of training outside, you know, on the tarmac or like on the turf, you know, a lot of sled work. A lot of hypertrophy training, if you will. But it's just grinding. You know what that's like, man. It's just a lot of hard work and just trying to, you know, do the best that I can to be ready to come and deliver when it's game day.
Man, you're gonna crush this role. I can't wait. I love that you said that you're training on the tarmac. Right. So and that the fact that you're on the tarmac means it's about 120 degrees on that tarmac.
Oh, it's warm down here.
Well, man, really quickly, I know that a lot of fans are super excited that we are introducing JSA after all these years. And what is it about Adam Smasher, which, by the way, is one of my favorite characters, especially, you know, when you see him just grow so large and everything is like just so badass and yes, and powerful. What is it about the character that attracted you?
You know, man, I think Al, because, you know, the real name, Al Rothstein, I feel like he really has something to prove, especially with his lineage of where his, you know, his grandfather was kind of, you know, a villain. And he's got quite a spirit to just help. And what I love about the character is that he goes through this transformation throughout the film where I think he's not expecting the world of being a superhero, because this is, you know, his first mission. It kind of just like hits him across the face. And so it's this journey that he goes on of what it means to be a superhero. And he gets to really see someone like Black Adam, who takes a different approach, clearly, to, you know, solving a problem or fighting, you know, bad guys. And it's an exciting character. It's a young character. It's a new, fresh face. And I don't mind being the size of the Eiffel Tower, the Empire State Building. That'd be pretty tight.
You know, I've seen some of the early like previs and renditions, and I got to tell you, it's so cool to see Adam Smasher next to Black Adam, and how, especially when your character, you know, just becomes even more powerful and he grows. It's just such an incredible visual to see Adam Smasher just so big and badass, and, you know, Black Adam just reduced. but it's awesome, man. And I'm so happy you're on board. And I know you've been working your ass off. And personally, for me, too, I want to thank you so much for working so hard. This has been a passion project, a dream of mine for many, many years. So I thank you. My heart is full of gratitude, brother, for all the hard work that you're going to put in. And this is only the beginning. I can't wait to get on set with you. And we're going to crush this movie.
I'm so stoked, man. I can't wait. Thank you for having me aboard. So grateful. Seriously.
Wow, so cool.